We welcome you back. Mother-daughter relationships. Is yours good or filled with pain and high drama? It's an interesting dynamic, and with Mother's Day approaching, perhaps time to revisit it. Dr. Rachel Glick is a counselor for the Soul Searchers here to talk about it. And you recently wrote about this in one of your blogs about mother-daughter relationships. And let's be honest, some of them are not so good.
No, I hear all day, actually.
Yeah.
About some very painful feeling criticized or not accepted, but there's also a lot of good stories about moms.
Yeah, but too. Is it something like, well, I'm going to speak from experience. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm a mother of a 20, almost 24-year-old now. Mm-hmm. Used to go head-to-head in her teens. Oh, it was just, now we're the best of friends.
Yes.
What in the world happened there?
Well, developmentally, a lot is changing for the daughter in terms of really coming into her own, but it's also commonly like when we're not living together anymore helps.
Right.
And the more that we can respect and appreciate their individuality, then it gives them space to be able to come and connect with us even more.
But is there a place where it might be a problem because it's like, I'm still the mom and you have to respect that. Mm-hmm. Sure, we're friends, but.
Yes. A lot of people have really different views on how much to be friends, how much to keep it mom-daughter. But I always find a balance is really good because you want to always keep that space of the person who birthed you, that you have that person to look up to on some level. But it does change to become more woman to woman as the daughter gets older.
Right. And do you find in your office, based on experience with some of your clients, that this time of the year, Mother's Day, is a time where a lot of these relationships heal?
Some people, it can trigger a lot of different things. Some people are mourning. Some people are adopted and it triggers issues about that. Some people open their heart more and want to do something to help heal that relationship. But I think it happens all year round. But I think on Mother's Day, it's obviously more present in our mind and in our focus.
What would be the first step for somebody to take, say, on Mother's Day to heal a problematic relationship?
I think that one of the most important things is to really try to understand the other's view and not get into the right or wrong kind of thinking and try to get the ego out of the way of how you might feel your own insecurity or your own unworthiness being triggered and really try to understand. And everyone wants to be appreciated and really valued for who they are, especially in this very intense kind of dynamic between mother and daughter. So really putting effort into showing and making it visible how much you value that each other.
Why is the mother-daughter dynamic different than the father-son?
There's something about the, it's kind of a soul-to-soul connection. I don't know if you find this to be the case, but as a daughter and a mother of a daughter, adult daughter, I notice that there's sort of a lineage that we're all kind of working through something very similar together. And so I think there is, and fathers and sons have a very close bond too, and mothers and sons as well, and fathers and daughters. But
yeah.
I think this, something about the mother-daughter bond, there's a lot of similarity and affinity that we experience, and a lot of our dreams and hopes and wishes go into our daughter's lives.
Boy, I feel like we could talk about this for a long time.
I know.
We were walking out of the gym yesterday, and I was hugging her arm in arm, and she's like, Mom, get off me. I go, I will always be your mother,
you
and I will always need hugs, okay? Don't ever forget that. Well, thank you.
Yes.
It's a very insightful blog if you want to read about it. We've got a link on our website as well as our Fox 2 News app. Thank you very much, and happy Mother's Day.
You too.
All right, we'll be right back.
In my daughter's eyes, I can see.